Hey guys, Andrew here, and welcome back to another episode of Nekojishi. We last left off, we had talked a little bit more with Ragu, and started heading back down the mountain. We got asked a very serious question about, do you or do you not wish to go home? And some people pointed out that there are bad endings in this game, a lot of them. And I am not pleased with that fact, because boy oh boy, is that not the funs. So, that just means we have to be even more careful. So, I'm gonna go ahead and say I think I will go back eventually. I'm not sure if I want to or not. I need time to think about it.
If you need time to think, you still shouldn't go with the other cats. Because who's to say when you'll ever be able to return?
Maybe I just don't want to feel like I must live my whole life at home.
So you wish to stay away for a while?
Yes, so I'm thinking of helping them out for a while.
Liao, don't you think it's a bit insincere to help them just because you want an excuse to stay away from home?
If I go, I'd do my best to help. You know I'm hesitant because this is a big deal that will change my life.
So, you will go home eventually after helping them out for a while?
I guess you could say that.
Well, then I still don't encourage you to go help them. It would be easy enough to deal with the small kitten, but how would you be a Jatong after promising to be the Aboriginal's Oracle? As long as you can go back home eventually, I don't care what you do in the meantime. No matter what, Liao, you are the son of Lin family, and I can't see you leave without doing anything. Their troubles are not your troubles. You don't need to provide them any service, and especially not give your life to their cause.
What if I say I wish to go help the others?
Then I'd have to let you go, but I wouldn't feel good about it. Especially not if you go be the Aboriginal's Oracle. Of course, as your family's guardian, it would be sad for me to see you go off to be the Oracle of another tribe. Please don't promise to help them before thinking about it thoroughly. At least, try to think about all the angles before deciding.
I know. I won't make any rash decisions.
That's a good boy.
Tiger pat my head, but this time it felt less calming than usual. We continued down the mountain in silence. I felt like Senpai was a bit peeved at me for speaking with Tiger all the way down the mountain, so I thought I should browse the stalls of the metro station with him and buy some of his favorite snacks. To make up for leaving the two cats to walk down off the mountain in silence while I spoke with Tiger, I bought Senpai a hot dog and a tea-flavored ice cream for Leopard. Leopard looked awkwardly at the ice cream until Senpai got one, too, and demonstrated how to eat it. I thought it was very cute. Tiger sat off on the side watching us. I don't know what to say. He didn't join in the fun, nor did he stop us from having fun. Senpai did his best to joke around, and we went home. A few days after our touring trip, it's time for the Tomb Sweeping Festival. I should have bought a ticket in advance if I wasn't too busy on my stuff. And now it's too late anyway, so I'll just let it go. Dad called and asked me when I'd be visiting. I answered that we have exams right after the vacation, so I was planning to stay and study. He didn't argue.
Liao, I understand your predicament, so I'll only ask once. Are you sure you don't want to go home for the holiday?
Yes, I just don't feel ready.
That's a shame. I was going to introduce you to all the other gods.
You mean, the other guardian tigers?
Like I told you, each statue holds a guardian tiger. If you like beastmen, then you'd be happy being surrounded by so many.
The temple back home is quite big, but there are so many statues. If all the guardian tigers are as big as the one I've seen, there's no way they'd all fit. I thought it very amusing to pretend how all the tigers scatter around the courtyard playing chess, gossiping, and just hanging out. But if I go back now, won't they all have a million questions to ask me? It may be best if I don't.
I get it. They can be a hassle. I'll just tell them in advance not to smother you all day, okay?
They shouldn't ask me about returning home, about life in Taipei, about studies, about girlfriends. They don't even know that I'm gay, and I don't want to explain about it.
That's true. I'll do my best. But sometimes they do like to joke around. Anyway, you'd have to get used to them sooner or later.
What about Leopard and Senpai? If they come along, wouldn't it be awkward?
It's best if Leopard didn't come. An Aborigine god coming to a Han temple is like asking for trouble.
Exactly. That's why I think it's best to not go back yet. I have many things to take care of first.
What about summer break? You can't stay here for the whole summer.
Well, we'll see when it comes.
Alright, if that's how it is, quickly make a decision so that the others can leave.
I know. I don't want to turn anyone away, but if we keep this up, there could be many more problems. I was always feeling nervous. Maybe I should just decide already. Yes, please do so. Because the sooner that's over, the sooner we can actually just start fast going towards the actual good routes for everyone. A day before the festival.
Liao? Yes, okay. I keep hesitating in my head and saying, like, is that the right name? Is it Liao? Liao? Yeah. Liao, you for sure aren't going back tomorrow?
For sure. I have to prepare for the midterms. Why?
Who cares about midterms? Unless you're trying for a scholarship.
Even if I'm not, I still don't want to fail.
Liao couldn't possibly fail, so let's go out and have some fun!
I guess we could, but we have been hanging out a lot, or we have been going out a lot lately.
Can we please go out again just this once?
No. Sorry, Senpai, I really have to study.
When you'll get to be a junior, you'll see that only freshmen care about studying.
I am a freshman, though. While I am a student, I should study.
Liao is just looking for an excuse not to take me out.
If you insist, then I'll really use this as an excuse.
Fine, I get it. Even if this is our last chance.
Huh? What do you mean?
Nothing. Keep on studying.
Okay.
I was just planning to go back home and get some things. I just wanted to tell you that I could be out until late.
Oh, okay. I know.
Okay, see you later.
But later that night, Senpai didn't return.
What's the kitten up to at this hour?
It is getting a bit late. I'll call and see what's up. I felt like something bad happened. The phone rang, but Senpai didn't pick up. If something came up, he should have at least left a message.
Maybe he's sleeping back home.
He talked about getting things ready, not about going to sleep. I wanted Senpai to go home, but not like this. When it turned midnight and there was still no sign of him, I could do nothing but take my worries to bed. Oh, are we losing them all one by one? The next day was the first day of the festival, but Senpai still didn't return. Even if I didn't go out with him, he shouldn't just leave with no word. I was a bit peeved, but also a bit worried. I didn't know what to do. In a time like this, talk with Guardian Tiger. I sat at my desk to study, but thoughts of Senpai's disappearance kept distracting me. I surfed some forms, distracting myself even more from studying.
Liao, are you still thinking about that kitten?
Yes, of course. How can he just suddenly disappear?
I would like to just forget about him, but it seems like you couldn't.
Of course, I wished for him to leave, but not like this. What if something bad happened?
I don't think anything bad could have happened. He's a guardian tiger, too. Yao Guai wouldn't do anything to him, and most people can't even see or touch him when he's not possessing a body.
So how could he suddenly just disappear?
I don't know, and I don't care, because I don't think he's in any danger.
Can you guarantee that?
No one. Sorry. No one can guarantee anything in this world. But if you really care so much, I can help you look for him.
How?
I can ask clairvoyant and clairaudience for help. We are far from home, but they can perhaps be found in a temple here in Taipei.
Taipei should have many mazu temples, right?
Not all gods and temples are the same. Even if they are mazu, it's like different classes in the same department. It would be weird to go to an unfamiliar temple and pray to an unfamiliar god for such a small matter. Although, even a temple that is not mazu could have a guardian tiger. The temple of the highest city god of Taipei has a guardian tiger. I could go there and ask him to help search.
Go to the temple of the city god.
Yes, most of us guardian tigers get along quite well. Luckily, guardian tigers can be found in many temples all over.
So you won't ask clairvoyant and clairaudience?
I couldn't go far away from my statue, but I could ask them to help me ask the city's guardian tiger.
So you'd ask clairaudience to go ask the guardian tiger for help?
Yes.
So it'd be like asking a friend of a friend to go ask their friend. Would they be fine with that?
Try this or try to ask around the internet forums.
If I try that, everyone could spread rumors about the disappeared student.
You'd think it wouldn't be a big deal if we involved gods.
I guess you're right. Should Guardian Tiger go ask to other gods? I don't want to bother Tiger. He's right. The rumors about us were bad enough, but what would happen if this news got out? If people heard of this, they'd be even more mistaken about our relationship. He said it simply enough, but I also know that for him to ask other gods to help is like sending him out to beg for favors. If Senpai couldn't be in any real danger, then it would be too much to ask of Tiger. I know, I'll just ask some close friends if they've seen him.
You're overthinking again. That kitten couldn't be in any big trouble.
He's always been prancing around me, so now it's weird that he's just vanished.
Isn't it nice without him dancing all around you?
Well,
I know. He'll probably be back in a few days. Now you should just stop distracting yourself and study for your exams.
Guardian Tiger pats my head. I just breathe out a sigh to release my worries. Oh, Senpai, where did you run off to?
Liao, yes, I want you to focus on your study, but don't you think the room needs a tidy up?
What? I take a look at the room. Messy, indeed. Usually, I wouldn't go this far when Senpai was here. He also helped clean here and there, so it was never a problem. However, Senpai is not here right now, and I am back to my old days, leaving everything the way it is.
These clothes have been left here for 3 days, stinky like hell. And there are takeaway boxes in the trash. Shouldn't you take it out every day?
I got it, but I'm lazy. These days, I'm kind of out of my mind.
Anyways, clean up quickly, now.
Okay. I start to clean as told. So many things to put away, keeping me busy for over an hour.
Liao, you forgot to turn on the washing machine. I did it for you.
Thanks. Tiger could turn on the washing machine. How did he do it? Poltergeist effect?
Kitten's desk also needs a clean. It's his stuff, but everything's inside your room. And the quilt on the floor. We can put it away while Kitten is not here. You don't really use it.
But somehow I feel Senpai won't come back if I pack up the mat from the floor. Pack it up! Tiger's right. Senpai is not here. It makes sense to pack up the mat for now. It is kind of blocking the entrance, every time I have to step across, which is rather inconvenient. Okay, I'll pack it up. I put the mat into the wardrobe and tidy up Senpai's belongings at the corner. Then I clean the entire room thoroughly as some exercise for my body, relaxing my mind from study. Not bad. I feel more energetic after the cleaning.
Right. Clean your room more often from now on, okay?
It is very tiring. It does give me more energy, but I won't always have this much stress prior to the midterm tests. I don't have the drive to keep it clean.
You must. A clean and tidy environment is very important for your physical and mental health. Instead of fighting illness, it's better to not get sick. In short, I'll be urging you to clean up from now on. Understand?
It's not like I don't want to clean up. It feels rather awful to have someone constantly stare at me.
Now it's tired. I'll help.
No need. Thank you for the offer. Leopard's help must be some spiritual phenomenon. He will be exhausted. What's more, many people will be scared to death seeing my tool clean on its own. I better not trouble him. Actually, I better ask him not to help. His kind offer really touches me. This time, I can only take the will of the deed. I don't know what that means. At the last night of the tomb sweeping holiday, Senpai is back. Senpai, where have you been these days?
Sorry, Liao. I went back to my hometown to pick up a few things, but my family kept me there. Sorry.
Going back home is okay, but why didn't you contact me at all? You didn't answer my calls. I was so worried.
Liao was worried about me? That makes me happy.
Everybody would feel worried about your sudden disappearance. What happened?
Nothing. My family took my phone away and cut my internet off. I couldn't contact anyone.
Your family is so strict.
Only this time. You know, it's just because of my sexual orientation. I've argued with them a few times on this matter. They found out my staying at Liao's home and exploded. Then it became so.
Hmm? Because of staying at my home?
They can't accept me staying with someone else. This is my body, and it's none of their business. I'm speaking from Yan Shu-Chi's point of view. He's very unhappy about it. As matters stood, it's hard for me to insist. Today, I'm actually here to pick up my stuff. I have to move back to my dorm.
But, Senpai, didn't you... Senpai came to my home to convince me to rejuvenate the temple. Now he's leaving without my promise. What about the temple?
No problem. I don't stay here, but we can still see each other. We have classes together.
Is it really okay?
It will be okay if Liao agrees to help rejuvenate the temple.
Senpai, be serious.
Very. I don't want to give Liao any pressure. To be honest, my situation is not very good, in every possible way. But I'm not quitting, as a matter of life and death. Liao, please.
Please what?
Thinking about discontinuing your studies temporarily? I'll help you with the whole process. And I'll solve your, And I'll solve your accommodation and living expenses. I just need your commitment and resolution.
But although Senpai says this, it's too sudden. Senpai has said it before, but leaving school for a year or two, how can I explain that to my family?
I understand, but I don't have any other solutions. We don't have many choices. I have to break it to you so you can prepare. The longer we wait, the harder it will become.
Senpai starts packing.
My stuff. Where's my bed?
I packed it away during the cleaning. It was hard to...
I see. It makes sense. I guess that's it. Liao, let me know when you decide. See you tomorrow.
Senpai leaves just like that. Although Senpai said see you tomorrow, I'm already used to his messing around this month. It's difficult to adjust to his sudden leaving.
I didn't know Kitten could be this outright. I thought he would be entangled.
Shu-Chi, not happy.
Leopard can feel Senpai is unhappy? I know Senpai doesn't want to leave, but I can't stop him. Senpai, how did we get here? About Senpai, should I talk to the other two big cats? Talk with Tiger? Tiger?
I know what you want to say. Let him. His staying here was trouble. As he said, you guys can still see each other. Nothing is wrong.
But it is because of his family. Senpai doesn't want to leave. Should we just let him go like this?
Or what? Beg his family to let him stay.
My call will only make things worse.
That's right. How can you stop him? This is a human's domestic problem. Even an upright official staff finds it hard to settle a family quarrel. It will be the same for gods. Even Goddess Mazu can't solve this problem. Give it up.
I find it hard to accept.
You weren't the one that wanted him to leave, or you were the one that wanted him to leave.
I have changed my mind. I don't want him to leave like this.
Then like what? Merry met, merry part. While you can't go to Miaoli with him anyhow. Right now, you are ruled by your passions. This is actually a great opportunity to say no to him. You don't need to feel guilty, or just imagine he's kicked out by me. What about that?
You have nothing to do with it.
That's why I said imagine. I'm asking you to let him go. Blame me whenever you regret, okay?
How could I do that?
Liao, your wavering is quite annoying. Don't you know that?
I know.
That's good. If there's anything you want to say, tell him tomorrow in person.
Yes. I go to bed, covering myself with my quilt. It's still early and I can't fall asleep, but I can't really do anything right now. Under the warm cover, I think quietly. Maybe I should have asked Senpai to leave at the very beginning. There wouldn't be so much trouble now. It has been 1 month. How could I simply say I wish I didn't become close with Senpai? Easy, you just did it. You just said it. After the holiday, midterm exams are about to start. This morning, I was kind of looking forward to Senpai coming to wait for me, but he didn't. His dorm is in the complete opposite direction with my home. It would be a pain in the ass if he waits for me to go to school together. Most of today's classes have exams soon. Senpai can't make time to be a visitor at these classes. However, he doesn't show up even on the one that doesn't have an exam. I can't find him during the lunch break. Eventually, we meet in the cafeteria.
Liao, it's been a long day. How did your exams go?
They were okay. What about Senpai? Any exams?
Of course, but not today. I didn't take any courses in this term, as you know.
That's why Senpai could come to my classes every day. Won't it affect his studies? Isn't it too late to think about it? How come Senpai didn't show up all day?
Liao misses me? I'm here now.
Senpai is waiting for me here?
Because Liao pretty much eats only in the cafeteria.
The cafeteria is cheap.
Many restaurants around school are also cheap. Liao is just too lazy to try a new place.
I'm in my freshman year, not so familiar with the food spots nearby. The cafeteria has many options. Nothing is bad here.
Liao is always eating alone. That's very solitary. Solitary.
I'm not eating alone. In the past month, I was eating with you. Besides, our topic is a secret between us.
If I'm gone, Liao has someone to eat with? Huh?
Senpai...
What's wrong? Why are you so serious all of a sudden?
Senpai just said, if I'm gone. Shouldn't it be, if you go to Miaoli with me?
Well, if Liao comes to Miaoli with me, of course we'll be eating together. But if Liao doesn't go, you probably don't have any friends to eat with, am I right? Eating with Kulau and the old man is not bad, but they are invisible to most people. You need some normal friends, otherwise you will be deemed as a weirdo.
Senpai, you said it was a matter of life and death. Why do you sound like you were leaving?
No, I think I've been trying too hard to chase Liao, but I can't convince you.
I guess he's talking. Okay.
Why not change a method? Maybe keeping some distance is better? As you said, Liao, it is a matter of life and death. You're not going with me even knowing this, aren't you?
This... because I have to leave school.
If you don't come, I might become a side street yaogwai and vanish.
Don't threaten Liao with this. The disappearance of your food god's power won't cause you to vanish. Becoming a yaogwai is far away from disappearing. You can always find another feud gong. No one wants to destroy you as long as you are being good.
Changing a boss is not easy. I've been following my feud gong for a long time. I don't want him to lose his power. With power or not, a god of soil is a god of soil. He will revive one day when someone brings offerings. However, it is very sad to see him being forgotten.
Many people in this world are pitiful. Why don't you help them all?
That's why I came to Liao. I know it's hard. In Liao's situation, leaving school a year or two is not an easy thing to do. I'm under great pressure from my family. I know how difficult it is to fight against the family. Liao's problem is not leaving school, but making your family accept you're leaving school, isn't it? I didn't know how hard it could be with Yan Shu-Chi's memories until his return to his hometown and his body. It has completely sobered me up. I feel bad for asking Liao to do the same thing. No family can accept this without a major change in life. But if such a major change happens to Liao, you probably could never go home again. So I'm actually thinking if I should give up. It's okay for me to become a Yao Guai again. Our temple will be desolate, but no one would die from it.
Senpai is giving up?
I don't want to be a quitter. Is Liao coming to Miaoloi? Right. Giving up or not doesn't really matter. I'm thinking to keep some distance. Liao and I can be mere friends. If Liao gets an opportunity, you can come and help. But if Liao can't help, it won't hurt too badly when we have to say goodbye.
Senpai, it's a bit late for saying that.
Hmm? Is Liao already in love with me?
Not at all, Senpai. Don't spoil the atmosphere.
But I don't want to put too much pressure on Liao's shoulders. Don't worry, we're still close. I'll come to chat with Liao every so often. This is the exam week, and I'm going to be busy. So is Liao, right?
Hmm.
Focus on exams. These things can wait.
Huh.
Okay, forget about these depressing topics. Let's go and eat. Kulau, let's go!
Senpai drags Leopard to a juice bar. He's going to buy some drinks. I'm kind of speechless and then feel worse. Tiger tries to comfort me and goes to buy dinner with me. Senpai and I both get food and sit down. I'm too tired to know what I'm eating. Senpai seems happy, trying hard to keep the atmosphere heated. Even Tiger jokes along with him as if performing a stand-up comedy. However, I don't understand why I'm feeling so down for Senpai's leaving. I've been wanting them to leave. Today's midterm exam of math. I believe I've been working hard for this exam, but I don't think I can pass it. I'm very bad at math, and I don't know how well my learn effect has been with my mind occupied by other matters. Wow, this is really degrading. After all, I did leave math to the last to review. Wow, I guess this was the rush job part? Or something. Man, this entire string so far has just been not good. I look at Leopard, who is looking around curiously in this depressing classroom as if he had never seen so many people writing papers together. He had his eyes around in the previous exams, but I didn't pay much attention. Today's situation. I glance at Tiger, who is reading in the last row, paying no attention at me. A good opportunity for me. I don't want to fail mass. All I need is to pass. If I ask Leopard to help... Should I ask Claude Leopard to cheat? I don't know! Should I? With that out of the way, I'm gonna go ahead and say thank you guys for watching. If you like to see, go ahead and sorry, I'm having a head trauma. I'm like starting to adapt to how this is written, and I'm trying to speak in the way it's written. In any case, if you like to see, go ahead and click subscribe. Otherwise, leave a comment in the comment section below. Tell me what I should choose. Should I cheat or should I not cheat? Does it matter to the good ending or the bad ending? Who knows? Tell me in the comments. In any case, as always, thank you guys for watching. See you guys next time, and bye!